Something smells good. I wonder what Lynn's cooking today.
Hey, Lynn, what's cooking?
Now here's your host, Lynn Austin.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to Hey, Lynn, What's Cooking? And you know what? February is the month of love, and I just love a good breakfast. Don't you love a good breakfast?
Definitely.
And especially if it's made by somebody that you love, right? Mm-hmm. Or you're making it for somebody you love. And my friends who I love are in the kitchen today. Rodger and Susan are in the kitchen to make a wonderful breakfast of French toast that is stuffed with a raspberry cream.
Oh, yeah. French toast.
Okay, and it is so, this is so incredibly easy. There's a couple steps to it, but the end result is so incredibly yummy. But first we're gonna get started, of course, with a toast. In the kitchen, we have to have a toast. French toast.
French
get
toast.
Get it. Okay. But this is a cup of love. It's coffee, kind of a dark coffee, you know, rich, like bold coffee. And to that, we're gonna add a little bit of cream de coco. Make sure I have the right one. Yes, this. Put a cream de coco. A little bit of chocolate flavor. And to that, we're going to add a little bit of coffee liqueur into that. So this is full of love because you know why, Rodger? Because we have a little nickname for you.
Yes,
and we like to call you, we'll just finish off this coffee liqueur and just kind of divide it between three of us. That works. Papa Love, and I really don't remember why we started calling you Papa Love. It might have been after a few of your margaritas, maybe.
Well, okay.
And to top that off, we're going to use a little, you're my little cute little
creamer.
Little French vanilla cream. Look at that.
Mm. Yum.
Milk that cow.
So yes, I can milk that cow rather well. Look at that. I like the colors on there. Isn't that nice?
Wow.
That is nice. And we'll do a little toast to, here, Susan.
Thank you.
Love, friendship.
Okay.
And the month of February, which every day, you know, we celebrate Valentine's Day in February, but every day should be Valentine's Day, and you should just love everybody every single day.
Cheers.
And tell your loved one that you
Absolutely.
Love them.
Absolutely.
Cheers. Nice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's a good coffee.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I took a big sip of that. I could go for a little
There's
bit
There's a lot of love in there.
Oh, yes.
Well, keep your coffee with you.
Mm. Wow. Thank
Woo.
You.
That's
yes,
good.
Sir.
That's the way to start the day.
And we are going to move on. Of course, we have our griddle here, right here, so everybody can see what we're going to do. But we're going to get, I think we're going to put some bacon on there first, Rodger.
Okay.
And while I'm putting the bacon on, if you want to set your coffee aside and...
No.
You don't want to let go of your coffee. Now, you know, Rodger, how long have you two been married?
We just got started.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you just got started? Really? Well, that's nice. Really, Susan, how long have you been married?
No, I think it's maybe, you know, you start counting decades on your fingers.
Really?
Yeah.
And in those decades, now, Rodger, I don't mean to be putting you out there, putting you on the spot. Mm-hmm. How many times have you made Susan breakfast in bed?
Okay. He's thinking of
that's
that.
That's a long pause there.
In bed. Now, see, that's something that I wouldn't do.
Okay, so you would never serve her in bed.
I would never serve her in bed. No,
okay.
That's just...
Why? Why
that's
not?
That's just not right in my book.
Okay, so you can't eat breakfast in bed?
I would say not. No, just there's just something about sleeping and eating in bed.
So
it just doesn't mix.
But could you ever color outside of the lines and try to change things up a little bit? And how romantic would that be? Just the two of you snuggled in bed and eating.
That's not me.
Could you wear your little sexy little underwear and go out in the kitchen and possibly whip up this breakfast and say, okay, Susan, it's time to eat breakfast? Could you surprise her that way?
40 years ago, maybe.
Not now? You wouldn't make a breakfast?
I put on my robe today.
Okay, if you had your robe on.
Yeah, I put my robe on. It wouldn't be any sexy little night.
Oh my gosh, that's fine. You know what? Beauty is everything. It doesn't matter what size, shape you are. It's beautiful.
Okay.
The human body is beautiful, so we're going to have our bacon.
Yeah, I know about the bacon.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to move on to the filling.
Okay.
If you could possibly pass me that bowl that has cream cheese in it. Let's watch your cords there. Mm-hmm. And we're going to plug in that mixer. Just pass me the bowl and the mixer.
Okay.
I kind of didn't plug it in yet.
I can do that.
And
now, see, I can handle this. This is good.
This is good?
Yep.
Okay, our bacon is going right now, and that smells incredible. So you're in the kitchen, you're in your robe, you have the bacon going, and Susan's laying in bed, and she's like, something is smelling really good in the kitchen, and I'm not cooking it, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Or I'm thinking, where's the fire extinguisher?
But could you serve her the coffee in bed? Could she have the coffee in bed?
I could give her, a drink in bed.
Okay, so she's sipping the coffee in bed, and now you got your bacon going.
Bacon's going.
And then I need you to pass me that powdered sugar.
I can do that.
And a little bit of vanilla.
Okay.
And that other bowl is a raspberry jam. Any raspberry jam of your choice, or you can use strawberry, whatever you prefer. Okay. So, we have a brick of cream cheese in here that's softened already. And I added a little bit of powdered sugar to start with in there. We're going to add just a little bit more and some vanilla. Pure vanilla.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Roger, you can take that back for me.
Right.
And we're just going to dump this vanilla in here. And it's about maybe a teaspoon vanilla. Smell of vanilla.
Oh,
it just smells.
Yes.
Now that's a nice thing. You know you can wear vanilla as perfume too. Did you ever know that? You can do that.
That'd be great.
If you don't have perfume, just put a little dab of vanilla on there.
That'd get you
that actually vanilla is supposed to get in kind of that smell is supposed to get you in the lovely mood there for a little extra fun there after breakfast. Because it is the month of love, but we're gonna carry that on. Oh, Roger's taking see you know how to do bacon.
Yeah.
Bacon
well
into this, we're going to add a little bit of the raspberry jam. Give it a nice little pink color. We're going to use the rest of that in a minute. I'll show you in a couple minutes what we're going to do, but pardon my loudness. This is measuring. Instead of cream cheese, if you're going on the lighter side, if you're worrying about your little figure there, you can use yogurt too to that as well. So that would work. Okay, I'm going to take care of that for me.
You all done with it?
And, yep, we are finished with that. I'm just going to scrape this off of here. Now normally, you all know what I would do normally. If I wasn't on television.
You don't waste it, right?
Right. Now, I wouldn't waste it. Of course, I would call the kids in and say, hey, do you want to lick the beaters?
The kids aren't here.
Oh, that's right. Do you want to lick that?
I will. Okay. I'll do it civilly.
There's no way to do that the right way. See, he's getting ready for later, for after breakfast. You see those eyes that he gave you?
That's
he's like,
good.
I am ready.
Oh, that's awesome.
That is yummy. That's just a simple jam, whatever jam of your liking that went in there. You can use yogurt, you can use cream cheese, but we went the cream cheese.
Well, yeah.
And you know what? Not even the low fat. It just went for the whole
it is
loveliness.
Valentine's.
Go ahead. You want to Thank you. You're welcome. So your bacon is cooking, Roger.
Yep.
Your filling is complete. And we're just going to incorporate the size of the bowl into here. And that is done. You could take a sip of your coffee and you could say, Susan, breakfast is almost ready. Just a couple more minutes. Okay, we're going to set the filling aside over here. And then we're going to move on to our egg mixture because you have to dip your toast. And let me talk about the toast here for a second.
Okay.
I wanted something that, when I made this, that was something that was just a unit. Just talking about your unit. I'm sorry. Unit. You know, it's like one thing. I chose Hawaiian sweet rolls. Okay. And then a potato roll because what we're going to do, I won't get ahead of myself, we're going to make a little cut in there and then hollow it out and put the filling in there. So you don't have two slices of bread, it's just one,
like a pocket.
Really?
Yes, one pocket. Thank you. Pocket. Okay. But first, we will do the egg mixture. And then after we assemble our French toast, we're going to be doing, you're probably wondering what these are out here for. We are going to do the perfect round fried egg with a canning lid. So I have those already oiled and ready to go. So we're going to set those aside. Mm-hmm. So our egg mixture, Roger, this is going to be so easy. Susan, don't you just love this? Roger's just...
I love it. I'm
cooking.
Enjoying
it. Yeah, and you know what? He's going to take this home with him, and he's once a month... You're gonna make breakfast.
Wow.
Breakfast in the kitchen.
Yeah, we'll see.
In the kitchen. Coffee in bed. And I know you have special coffee. I know you have special coffee.
I do.
You have special coffee that you like. Special coffee. Mm-hmm. So make it even more so and just go in the bedroom. You've been married 40 plus years, correct?
Yep.
Just go, put your feet up, have that special coffee, and say, hold on a minute, Susan, I'm going to go in the kitchen and make you breakfast. Because you know what? There'll be another 40 plus years. I guarantee you.
Okay.
Guarantee you. Okay?
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
So, to the mixture, we're going, do you want to crack the eggs, or do you want me to crack them, or?
If you want me, if you trust me enough.
Trust you? Go ahead. Put about 4 eggs in there. Very nice.
It's a math question.
Can you get it? See that shell?
You know what? A little crunchiness doesn't hurt
you know
anybody.
What?
You're all right.
You got it out.
Yep.
Day late and a dollar short, right?
Now Susan's having her coffee. She hears the eggs cracking. She's like, yes. And she's sitting on her coffee.
She's not saying yes. She goes, what are you doing?
No, she's biting her tongue and hopefully that she gets out there and there's not a huge mess to clean up.
How many dishes do I have to clean?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's a trade-off. It's a trade-off.
And the floor.
It's a trade-off. Okay. Now, these eggs, I like to use a meat fork to mix my eggs because you simply just go like that. And
nice
I believe...
Five times.
It Why makes, do you like to use a meat fork?
Because it's bigger and the prongs are bigger and I think it mixes it faster and just nicer. I think it does a better job.
Right.
So we're just scrambling.
We're mixing
right
that.
Now.
You're going to continue to mix that. And to that, you can add whatever milk you have in the refrigerator. But if you're planning this ahead of time, it's a little bit thicker, half and half or whipping cream. And today I had whipping cream in the refrigerator, so because it's a special
whipping cream,
heavy cream. This is heavy cream.
All right.
We're not holding anything
You're
back.
Talking nice.
This is heavy cream. Whipping that cream. Is
gonna have
something
that nice
is
for the
thick.
Raspberries, right?
Yes, that is thick. And to that we are going to add. Did you bring over the cinnamon, Raj?
Not yet.
Okay, I will go get the cinnamon.
I follow instructions when I'm in your kitchen.
You know what? I did forget to tell you.
I don't make a move without you telling me to.
We're going
to
sprinkle some cinnamon in there to get him to do things. He's not my husband.
That's true. Okay.
Okay, incorporate all that cinnamon in there. And that's good. I love the smell of cinnamon, too. That is like, oh, that bacon. You know what, Raj? I think we're going to have to move that heat up on that griddle over there.
Okay, I can
a little bit. Or you know what he's going to do? He's going to have me come to your house and make breakfast. And hide. And hide. That's right. He's out of that. He's like, you're going to be there at 9:01, not any later. 9:01.
Oh, no. That's way too late in the day.
Okay. Oh, what time would you have me there?
Way too late in the day.
Really? What time would you have me there to make
breakfast? I think 7.
Holy moly, that's an early breakfast there, huh?
I mean, you know, we don't sleep all day.
You don't sleep. Well, maybe that's something you need to do in your next 40. You should just sleep in just a little bit later.
Oh, come on.
Get brunch. Brunch. Did you ever have brunch?
Not unless I have to.
Oh, man.
I think that sounds like a good idea.
You know what? Get up, have a Pop-Tart, and go back to bed. Oh,
no. You lost me.
Oh, my goodness. Pop-Tart? That's not breakfast.
No, this is the whole do over till you make this breakfast.
Oh,
now we have our bacon sizzling.
Oh, yeah.
It's cooking now.
That looks good for me, but what are you guys doing?
Oh, this is perfect. Okay, so we have our egg mixture, couple eggs, whatever milk that you prefer or you have in the fridge.
The half and half.
The half and half.
Or
the heavy cream.
Heavy cream.
Heavy cream, because that does look a lot nicer when there's not skim milk in there, I tell you.
All right.
And cinnamon. It's in our mixture because we're just going to set that aside. So we have our filling of cream cheese, jam, powdered sugar, and vanilla. Mm-hmm. Our bacon is going. So we're just going to set that aside, and right now we are going to work on our eggs and get those going on the griddle in another little corner. Because I'd love, if you don't have this griddle, then you use a couple different pans. But if you have the griddle, it's nice because these fried eggs, if you use this trick that I have, you can have everything going on the same time on the griddle. So you have your bacon on one side, your eggs are going to go on another, and the French toast is going to go on the other side.
Like a one skillet supper.
Can you,
one griddle?
You know what we're going to do? This is really good. We're going to move this bacon grease over here.
Oh yeah.
I was going to put butter on there, but I saw this
nice
bacon
flavor.
Grease, and we are not going to waste that bacon grease, are we, Raj?
No,
we're going to. We're going to lather that all
up
there.
There's a lot of love.
There's love. There's a lot of pop of love on that griddle. A
lot of love.
There we go. Oh, see?
Yeah.
Don't let him fool you. He knows how to work that griddle. Look at him.
Yeah. I can grill.
He does the outside grill.
Rod, I'm going to show you how to make these perfectly fried round eggs.
Okay.
Ooh, I had your shell on my hand here. Okay.
All right.
These canning lids. Because I don't know if anybody knows this or not, I have canning jars and canning lids that I don't can. I will just be upfront with you. I don't can. I don't like to can. But I love to use my canning jars and my canning lids for anything that I possibly can. So, can. You get it? I have taken the smaller one and I've coated it with cooking spray. And what we're going to do, we're going to crack an egg into a small little bowl. And we're going to put a couple of these in the corner here, Raj. Oh gosh, this smells so good. Why does bacon smell good?
It's just universal for anybody.
Okay.
We'll do one more on the corner there. So we can do our French toast up here.
Oh.
Okay?
All right.
We're going to place...
Lay of the land now.
What we're going to do is place this in here.
Oh, look at that.
And then when it's set, then you flip it over.
The whole thing?
The whole thing.
With the lid and everything.
With the lid and everything. And then we're going to take them off of the griddle, and then you just kind of go around the edges like you would do a cake, and you pop it out.
Isn't that clever?
Roger, you can do this. You can totally do this. If you don't have the candy, do you have the candy jar, Susan, at home?
I do.
Okay, just dig out those jars and spray them.
That's the perfect size for that.
Spray them.
Look at that.
Look at it go.
Okay. Huh.
Now, eggs. Is this the quart size lid?
Oh, I don't know. Quart smaller, yes.
It looks like
a little pint. I think it's a pint.
It's
a pint. Smaller. Quart's a little bit bigger.
Because I mean, it's a perfect size for one egg.
Yes. There you go. That's good. A pint.
Good deal.
Okay.
I know that. They threw me off there for a second. Sorry. Canning is not my thing.
Okay,
one more.
So you just kind of watch that like you would like any other egg.
Yeah, and I like to use, I like to use this too when I'm poaching my eggs and have it in a hot pan. You can poach them in a hot pan of boiling water and then just dump them. You have a little bit more control with a little small little bowl. Really okay, cool. So those are going. Our bacon is going.
Bacon's looking good.
And it is smelling so good in this kitchen that we are ready to assemble the
French toast.
French toast. And so we have our mixture, our filling. Now these are the buns. Like I said, I use the Hawaiian rolls. Those are square. And our little potato rolls. Just watch. We are going to cut a little sliver on the top.
Okay.
Or you know what? I think we're going to do it on the side here. We're going to go this way with this one. And use your finger to press it and hollow it out. Like so.
Okay.
And then the filling is going to go right in the
middle.
Looks
like a canoe.
It does kind of look like a canoe. Canoe. Isn't that a commercial, I think?
No.
I thought it was. Right?
Your commercial.
It's my commercial in my head.
Sort of like a Greek, what do they call those? Wait, pita? That you...
Yes. Okay. Yeah, like a pita.
Okay.
Yeah. And you're just going to fill it and you can have, the kids would love this too.
Oh yeah. It'd be fun.
Would you like to do a couple of your Susan? Because I have Rodger. But actually, you're supposed to be in bed sipping on your coffee.
Smelling the bacon.
Just smelling the bacon,
you know, Lynn,
and the
I would
eggs
be,
going.
I would be fine until I couldn't find something.
You really? You would call Susan in?
Oh, you better believe it. Hey! Honey!
Now you just wouldn't suck it up and just kind of improvise and just use something else.
Well, you know, I can improvise, yeah, but... I can't improvise if I can't find the tools or the trade.
Oh, well, that's
you can't
like,
build a house without a hammer.
Okay, now that's like going out in the garage and us trying to find something
exactly.
on your tool bench or...
You've
tells
got
you how
to
often
have,
he's in the kitchen, right?
Yeah.
If you're going to build something, you got to
okay.
have...
Okay, but knowing you, if yes. you would be preparing this meal ahead of time, you would go into that kitchen... And kind of scope it out beforehand and make sure you have everything, correct?
Well, he should, but.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because we've been to a few of Jimmy Buffett's concerts with you, and you open your truck and you have everything that everybody could possibly want or need packed in that truck.
That's a little different.
Well, just kind of have the mindset.
A little different.
It's being prepared.
I think you're making excuses here,
no,
Rodger.
No,
I'm not.
It's a little different.
That's what I'm thinking. I think that bacon's ready to go, because I don't know how crispy you really want that bacon.
Oh, this looks great.
Is that ready to go? That's
perfect.
Yeah,
it looks great.
Actually, we're just going to plate that up.
I don't know what
there.
Everyone else is eating.
Oh, those look perfect.
Oh,
perfect size.
This is awesome. Oh, my goodness.
Okay.
And such a pretty little platter, too.
Little heart,
it's a heart
for your,
heart
for your love. See,
right.
It's
That's
all
nice.
About the love.
It's all about the love.
Is this one
better? I got to carry
How are my eggs
slice
looking,
for you. They're looking good. They're boiling on top. We're just going to wait a few more minutes in order to flip them.
Okay. Well, I don't want to get ahead of the game.
Oh, don't get ahead of the game because we are going to
fill
these
to quiet,
and
right?
then we're going to dump
curious,
them.
I'm curious. I want to see happens so when you flip those over.
Hopefully they work.
Because
they
be
usually
perfect.
Do, and I'm like, I'm under a little bit of egg pressure, no pun intended. There's
they
a little pressure cooker here for
yeah,
our
well,
eggs.
We'll see.
Okay, so we have made a little hole inside of the bun. Like I said, I didn't use two slices of bread. I used a little fun little bun to keep it all in the middle. And we're going to take here, filling,
okay.
Our cream cheese, powdered sugar, vanilla mixture, And just put some.
Now, what are you putting in there? Tablespoonful?
I would say more of a good teaspoon. I think a tablespoon would be too much, and kind of flatten the side there, smooth it out. And then I do a couple. Okay. Do a potato. Have them ready to go on a platter. Like so. And this is thick, so make sure your mixture is thick and not runny, because you don't want it runny, because it'll just
come right out.
Yeah, it might come out a little bit, but it won't come out as much.
Okay.
See how thick that is?
A little thicker than yogurt.
Yes. See, that's way. If you're going the healthier way, it might run out a little bit. If you're going the healthier way, just add a little bit more powdered sugar.
Guys, if you're doing this at home and the first time, put that in consistency of mortar. Okay?
There we
Brick
go.
Mortar.
See, now he's talking garage thing. Talk, you know, like building talk. Uh-huh. Raj, that's not romantic.
Oh, it's not. The brick mortar that you're building.
Yeah, it's not romantic. You gotta stay away from that talk there of brick mortar. Why do you say that?
Mortar.
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 There you go. Thank you.
Yeah.
See, I don't talk that talk. I talk more like, this is fun loving in the middle there. It's full of love.
That's right.
That is just goodness right there. That is just yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay, a couple more. And then, do you want to dunk them into the egg bath, Raj?
Dunk
them? Or dunk them. You're just going to...
Like a basketball?
Dunk? Well, no. You're just going to place them.
Okay.
Just a little bit of egg that wasn't mixed right there. That was bugging me. Sorry.
What are you saying?
Okay.
Did you do this right?
I'm watching. Oh, your eggs are setting right there. Nice.
Okay.
There. Okay.
Okay.
So I'll do the first one, and then you can do
it. All right. Show me how to do it.
Just kind of... Flip it and roll it.
Roll
just
it
to give
around.
It a little egg bath.
Is that what you call that?
Yeah, it's an egg bath.
Okay.
See?
All right.
It has stayed
in there. Which side
do
you put down first?
Oh, it doesn't make a difference.
Makes no difference?
Mm-mm. Okay, well, let's put it right there
because it's covered with
now, now, you have the bacon going there. And if you don't have bacon, you can use olive oil. You can use whatever oil you want in your pan. You can use butter, whatever you want to coat your pan. But we had that lovely bacon going, and that just brings a whole... flavor to itself. Okay.
Now, about my eggs good?
Eggs are good. Eggs
I'm worried
are good.
About my eggs.
Well, you know what? We can check them out a little bit if you want to. Oh, yeah, they're ready to go. They're ready
That's
to flip. There you go. You want to flip
them? I was worried about my eggs.
They're perfect like that. Right. That's perfect. We're going to watch Raj and have a sip of coffee. Oh, this is hard work.
There we go.
Oh! It's okay. It's
okay.
All right. It's all right. It's all good.
That was for you.
That's for you.
You always like your eggs.
It's okay.
Hard,
it's
you?
All right.
That's right.
She's just happy that somebody else is making them for her.
All right. Mm-hmm. Good deal. Yeah.
Nice and easy. Perfect.
Oh, there you
Perfect.
Go.
Perfect.
Okay.
One more. Ooh.
It's kind of going up
it's kind
inside
of, it's,
there.
It's kind
of
freaking me out.
Of its own.
It's alive.
It's like a snail or something going out of its shell.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
All right. Chase
you want me to help you?
No.
No, okay.
I can do this. The pressure is on.
Oh, goodness. It's like a hockey game, isn't it? You'll get it. There you go.
Look at you.
Yeah.
You got all the tricks of the trade, don't you?
She does.
Perfect.
There we go.
Okay.
They're going to be go. Perfectly fried round eggs.
I'm okay. good for 75% of the time.
It's all good. Now we're going to continue with our
egg bath.
Our egg bath.
Okay.
So like drawing Susan a bath before she ate breakfast would probably be out then. I just thought about that.
Man, you are reaching.
Well, okay, I'm just thinking, married, you have to freshen up things a little bit, Raj, when you've been married over 40 plus years. So that wouldn't be a problem. Susan, I made a bath for you with candles going and a cup of coffee. And if Susan told your children this, they'd probably check you in somewhere.
About
they'd be like, what is wrong with Dad?
Make me a nice gift certificate to an Italian restaurant.
But you know what? It's cheaper, Raj, to be at home and do these fun things.
Yeah, okay.
Making a bath for your wife is inexpensive, except for the water. Here you go. Dunk into the bath.
Into the bath. Here we go.
You are never going to come back in the kitchen again. He's like, I'm done.
Okay.
Just kind of take it and you're okay. Get your hands in the egg a little bit.
Oh,
a little bit.
Okay. Mortar, guys. Mortar.
Okay.
All right. Give me
another one.
All right.
Look at how nicey the mixture is still staying into the little bun. I like his Hawaiian rolls too because he's added a little bit of sweetness to them. And the potato is
making the pocket.
Thank you.
Because I don't like the two slices of bread. And this is, you know, this is actually good.
Yeah,
I mean,
if you want
just a little bit, this is perfect. And I'm going to show you how to plate it up on a plate. And you're going to knock Susan's socks off. But she probably don't know if she sleeps with socks in bed or not. But
she can come
to the kitchen table and have her socks on because you're not going to serve this in bed.
Now, we're going to be starting to talk about Dr. Oz.
Okay. Do you watch Dr. Oz?
Occasionally. You know, he talks about sleeping with socks on.
And what does he say about sleeping with socks?
If you're sick, you sleep with your socks on.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
So I don't like her sleeping with her socks on, but...
Oh, if I'm freezing, if it's 20 below, you
yeah,
have to
that
sleep.
Too. Well, you know,
okay, we'll put one more on there. Stuff this and we'll set these aside.
These would be perfect little portions for the grandkids,
yes.
too.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And you could freeze these, too. You can make these ahead of time and freeze them.
Really?
Yes, you can.
Okay,
we're going to set this aside. Those are cooking in our, I think our eggs, Roger, are going to come out right about now. And I'm going to show you how to do that.
Okay.
We're going to let our French toast cook a little bit on there. And we're going to flip that one right there, the first one that you put on.
I sure will.
Wipe your hands there. You're good to go.
Yep.
A bit of our egg mixture. Perfect. Nicely browned. They're all heating up over there. You know what? Pass me those eggs. Those eggs are going to come right here.
Alright.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Now, I like to. These are going to be a little hot, so.
And then the magic here.
You just keep on looking and... It's kind of like it's like a cake. Look at that.
Oh, how nice.
I mean, look at that.
Isn't that cool?
Yes.
I'm going to put a little thing so I don't burn my counter. Those perfectly round fried egg. Perfect. They popped out nicely because we greased them with the cooking spray. If you don't have cooking spray, you can use butter or oil, whatever you have.
Oh, the lids are nice because they've got that little ledge on the bottom.
Oh, my God.
Look at that. And you can add them to a sandwich. You can. But we have carbs, but I thought right now we have the carbs in the French toast. So you can just plate that up just like that. Put a little slice of bacon on top of your egg. But I'm going to show you in 1 second how we're going to... plate these up. Go around you, Raj. Okay. To our plate. This is for Susan now. Right, not us first.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna take some the leftover raspberry.
Yes, raspberry.
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna swirl it. Like so. Where's that done one right on top of there?
Are you kidding me?
The front one. The done one. What do you mean? Am I kidding you?
Are you kidding me?
Oh, where's my pop sugar? Okay. You're like, Susan, I know I can't serve you in bed because we don't do the,
we're going to put that
right there.
We don't do in bed eating.
We don't do in bed eating, Susan. other one that's almost done? Which one was the?
This one, I think.
Okay.
You want it?
Yep.
Where'd you
right like next it? To it, like. So, like that.
It's all about the presentation.
And you add a little bit of powdered sugar. If you don't have a shaker, you can just take your time with your finger. Okay, that didn't sound good. I was going to leave that alone. And on the side of that, now if you're okay, now I'm okay with everything being on my plate. Okay, but if you're not, you can have separate plates, but we're going to add your egg. Today we're just going to add this aside because you have your little piece of bacon and your perfectly round fried egg.
You do.
How pretty.
And there is your...
Oh, I would never believe you
would
do that.
Love of your breakfast, right? Yeah. Love of your breakfast. And Roger will do this once a month. Once a month. It's not that hard. Or he'll give you a Pop-Tart and say, 7 o'clock in the morning.
Lynn will be here in an hour.
Lynn will be here in an hour. Well, maybe 2 hours. But you can. I want you to try that, Susan.
Okay.
And then Roger, I'm going to plate up
that
yours.
Looks awesome.
Okay, wow. Next one.
I feel like a queen over here.
Very pretty.
Don't get used to that feeling.
I want you to try. Oh, wow. Well, you can tell they've been married for 40 plus years here, Roger. Put one on there for yourself, and I want you to try that. And I am so glad that you guys came in the kitchen today to share the love in the month of February and to learn how to make a good breakfast, because we love a good breakfast on Hey, Lynn, What's Cooking. And I am just tickled pink that you guys came in. And I hope that you will carry this on at home with your wife, or just call me and I'll be there in the brunch hour.
I'll have you on feed.
Oh, this is delicious.
Thank you for tuning in to Hey, Lynn, What's Cooking. I hope everybody has a good day and a wonderful month of February full of love. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.